Hey guys, how's it going on this Monday? Thank you for coming back to my channel or my Instagram if that's where you're watching this video. I appreciate your support, your subscription, your follows. And if you are not already following or subscribed, make sure you do so. Every Monday, I post a market update of what's going on in the Phoenix real estate market. So you don't want to miss that info. I also post videos about neighborhoods here in Phoenix, home tours, and tips for buyers and sellers. So make sure you follow me to keep up to date with all of that. All of this market data that I share comes from the Cromford Report, which is a subscription that I have. They analyze data from the MLS here in Phoenix and give us realtors who subscribe all of that great information to share with their clients. So I am here sharing that with you guys every Monday, and I think it's helpful. I hope it's helpful for everyone. And let's jump in. Today I'm talking about a few things I want to follow up. Because we've been talking about iBuyer activity and investor activity. And so we now have some data that is the latest affidavits of value, which basically gives us the intended use of purchases recently. So I have data now comparing August of this year to August of 2020 and the differences between the intended use of buyer purchases. And it's pretty interesting. So first, sales of homes intended to be primary residences this August are down 14% to 6,906. Sales of homes intended to be rented are up 97%, and that number is 2,176. Again, this is comparing August of 2021 to August of 2020. Sales of homes intended to be secondary residences are up 98% to 2010. So our intended to be rented homes and our secondary residences are both up significantly compared to last August, which falls in line with what we've been talking about, lots of investor purchases and iBuyer purchases. The sales of homes intended to be primary residences are actually down 14%. So I found all of that information helpful and interesting. I thought you guys would as well. One thing that we're seeing, and I've talked about this the last few weeks, is that our demand has spiked up and increased pretty significantly in the last month or so. And a lot of that, we believe, is from this iBuyer and investor activity. But one thing that we're seeing is that demand is actually in a particular price range, 400,000 to 800,000. The number of listings under contract has surged over the last month or two since the end of July. Last year, we were seeing a lot of iBuyer purchases with an average sales price of about two in the 200,000s, mid 200,000s. Now, when we look at their sales price, it's in the mid 400,000s on average. So it's likely that this major surge in listings under contract between the 400 and 800,000 range is being fueled by these iBuyers. Now, also, it's a very popular price range. You can get a good size house for that number here in the Phoenix area. So there is probably some true demand behind that as well. But definitely think that that big surge is another thing that these iBuyers or investors are doing in our marketplace. So that's that update as far as intended use and what our investors are doing. Thought all of you would find that interesting since we've been on that topic lately. But let's also talk about the CMI, which I know all of you come here to hear an update on every week. So briefly, the CMI is the Cromford Market Index. It's an index that was created by the Cromford Report, where I get all of this data from. And it helps us understand supply and demand in the market, as well as where our prices are going. So the CMI is just the initial indicator, and it points us in the direction of price appreciation and if prices will be going up or down. It is not something that we predict. It is the predictor of all things, really. So the CMI in a balanced market is going to be sitting somewhere between 90 to 110 as a range, as an index. But when we are in a seller's market, that number is going to be anywhere over 110. And when we're in a buyer's market, it's going to be anywhere below 90. We've been well over 110 for a long time. Today we're sitting at 348.5. And lately we've seen the CMI stop dropping as it had been for the last 5 months. And it's kind of coasting now. So 348.5, supply is at 33, which means that we're about 67% below normal. And our demand is sitting at 114.9, which means we're 14.9% above normal for demand. Demand went up again since last week. The demand right now is rising faster than our supply, which is what has slowed down the direction and the pace of the overall CMI. Where we're sitting today is a comparable market to where we were at in about November, December of 2020. So if you were looking to buy or sell around that time and remember what the market factors were like, that's kind of where we're at now. Since then, we surged upward, went absolutely crazy, and then started to come down, and now we're coasting kind of back at that level again. So we'll see where things go from here. We've definitely cooled a little bit, but we basically went from insanity to just a frenzy. So if that's any descriptor for you that will help understand where we're at in this market, still definitely a crazy seller's market. It's just not as wild as it was at the beginning of the year. I have a few other statistics to share that will help you compare kind of where we were at before and where we are today. So let me peek at my notes over here to share that with you. So the number of sales over the asking price, that's been something that we see very consistently in this market. Right now, that is at 51.3% of sales are selling over the asking price. That's down from 60% at the height of our seller's market. So that's come down pretty significantly, but still, half of the homes that sell are selling over the asking price. So don't forget where we are right now. Median over list price. So the median amount that is being paid over the list price when we go over asking, that median number right now is $11,100. And at the height of our seller's market, that was at $20,000. So that has also come down. Also, our average sales price per square foot our average sales price per square foot over the listing price, okay? So this is a similar factor to the median amount over the list price. Is now sitting at 0.6% over the listing price. That was previously 1.8% over the listing price. So again, that's come down. And our days on market is sitting at 9 days on market right now, and we were at 6 days on market at the height. So those are a few indicators that help us see where we've come, how we've softened, if you can call it that. So again, don't forget, we are still very much in a seller's market. We've just softened from the height and the craziness that we were at the peak in like April and May-ish. April was pretty much the craziest time. So things have changed, but we're still in a crazy seller's market. I'm going to continue to track all of this information and share any breaking news as it relates to the iBuyers or intent for these purchases so we can keep on tracking that story. And if you have any questions or you want any further detail on anything, you can always reach out to me by call, text, or email, or check in my description. I've got a link there where you can set up a time to chat with me if you're thinking about buying or selling in the Phoenix real estate market. Thank you so much for following and tuning in this week. I appreciate it so much. I hope everybody has a great week, and I will be back later in the week with another video. Have a good one.